So previously we left off with two mass extinctions, the first one happening in the Ordovician and then with the Devonian, which were both a lot of ocean life that was affected by climatic change. This one here more to the oceans cooling off. In the Devonian one, we actually think that the oceans warmed up and caused salinity levels that was just unsuitable for the life there. So I like to think of the Devonian as, if we think about our coral reefs, you might have heard of them being what is called bleaching, which means the water temperature gets too high, and it causes the whole coral reef to kind of break down. This is something that probably was very similar to what happened during the Devonian extinction. Our Permian-Triassic mass extinction was probably one of the largest extinctions on geologic record. Up to 90% of all life went extinct during this extinction. So this is much larger than our dinosaur extinction during the Triassic, and we'll talk about that here next, is that there was just several things that were happening that caused to this extinction. The first one was increase in volcanic activity. And when you have that increase in volcanic activity, you have dust and gas is being spewed into the atmosphere, which can cause the atmosphere to change its chemical state. And so it caused for a lot of different types of gases to be present. There is evidence of a comet and meteor impact during this time. And then also a release of methane into our atmosphere, which normally is housed way down below in the Earth's crust. And it was released either quickly due to glaciers melting off and or huge faults allowing this methane to seep up that is normally housed way deep down in the earth layers. And so with all of these factors, it just caused for a powerful or a very large climate gas change. And so if we look here, original increase in greenhouse gases because of human activity, we can see that happening here. What happened is that you had these three factors that were contributing, causing the Earth's temperature to rise up, because you had high energy there, and then the methane. And then what happens is once you get all of that soot and rock and gases in the Earth's atmosphere, it causes for this like almost flip and causes for a great cooling, and because it causes almost like a nuclear winter. So this was a huge, like all of these factors right here caused the Earth to become really unstable for ecosystems to be successful. And that's where you see this 90% rate of change, is that it just pretty much wiped out everything. So we normally say this Cretaceous mass extinction is our dinosaur extinction. So this one here was a little bit before, which kind of made way for the Earth to be really, really warm for dinosaurs to be really, really successful. And then something happened again, and it caused our very large reptiles to kind of die off there at the end of the Mesozoic, or the end of the Cretaceous period. And so 65% of all of the life died. The reptiles were the ones that were really unsuccessful at being well adapted for the new climate that the Earth was inhabiting. And so reasons that we think this extinction occurred is there is evidence of a meteor impact at the Yucatan Peninsula. It has been found. It has been radioactively dated to the same era of the Cretaceous, where we can see those reptiles and those dinosaurs dying off. We also can see a huge process of photosynthesis breaking down, meaning that once again, the environment was not suitable for sunlight to be making it to the plants. that create photosynthesis, and so it caused for a very big cooling of the earth. And then ultimately there is evidence of an increase of volcanic activity. But the big one is the meteor, and that meteor, when it crashed into the earth, sent up a whole lot of dust, which caused quite a bit of a problem. And so, very dramatic picture there. But the initial collision obviously was catastrophic. It hit here, somewhere in this area. It is visible from space, and once again, it has been radioactively measured to pinpoint that same time era of the Cretaceous. And so all that dust was sent in to the atmosphere, which kind of led way for mammals to be really successful. So it opened the door for small mammals to kind of dominate the earth. Early mammals were, they were like more of a shrew, house cat size, because they had to be small and quick to get away from their predators of dinosaurs and reptiles. But over time, with the reptiles being gone, they were able to kind of be more successful and dominant and change their eating habits as well. So over time, mammals were able to grow into size and take over different ecosystems because they became the predators. Some cute pictures. So the bigger question is where are we heading now? Now that we have a grasp of what's happening, there's lots of endangered and threatened species due to ecosystem changes, to climatic changes in general, too. What's going to happen to them as we move through and look at scientific data to try to figure out what's next? So hopefully this was helpful with our different types of extinctions that have occurred geologically.